Interactions. We'll cover two major things here. We'll cover basic hover animations. We'll actually do this with CSS. And then we'll go into Webflow Interactions to build a page load animation that won't only turn heads, but it'll turn minds. Sara, what does that mean to you?
Yeah, I was just going to ask you the same.
Great, so how does...
All right.
Let's start with button. So here's a button. With a button selected, we can always style things. We know we can do this. We can change the padding. We can change the padding here. We can do a lot of stuff like that. Undo because it was better before. But with this button selected, let's go over to the right. And we can go in to change what happens on hover. So what happens on hover? Right now, nothing special, but we can change that. So if we want to change the color so it gets maybe brighter on hover, we can do that. And because we're editing in the hover state, we can preview. Let's just escape out real quick. We can preview what it'll look like when you hover over. That's okay. Let's go back into hover because there's a better type of design we can use for this, so we're not necessarily changing the background color. Let's reset that. And instead, let's mess with the box shadow.
So that's good.
Let's increase the distance.
Yeah, a little bit.
Like that?
Let's do 40.
Okay, so you want to round this to 40 and maybe the blur?
A little bit more, yeah.
Okay.
That's it.
Okay, so what happens now? Click out. We can see kind of an effect. It's okay. Not great. Let's add a transition. So what a transition does is it interpolates between two points, right? So we have none, that's what we're editing in right now, and we have hover. Point one is none, point two is hover. So let's go back to none. If we go down to the bottom, we can add a transition. What kind of transition? Well, the type is opacity by default. We don't want to change opacity because we haven't changed opacity. So there would be nothing that happens. But if we change opacity to box shadow, now if we hit escape, we can see it's animating that box shadow. Maybe it's a bit dramatic right now. Let's slow it down. What do you think is a good number here?
Like 400?
400, and that'll take 4/10 of a second. So if we simplify that fraction, it'll take 2/5 of a second. But if we hover over, we can see over 400 milliseconds going in and hovering out, we can see that animation play out. But it's CSS. We've applied not only this styling to this button, but we've applied it somewhere else too. We applied the button class to this button. Even though it's a combo class, it's going to take those base styles, including the shadows and that transition. So when we hover over here, we'll see that same effect. We won't see it up here because remember, this is just a modified version of these nav links. We just created a CTA version of this nav link. But on anything that uses the class button, we can see this effect. Now, we could take it a lot farther than this. We could, of course, add something else. So if we go to hover, let's see what happens if we add another change here. Let's do a transform. So 2D and 3D transforms, we hit the plus, it opens this up. We can move left and right, we can move up and down, we can move in and out. You don't see that right away because we don't have perspective set up, but let's actually switch. It'll reject these values when we switch over to rotate. And let's just rotate about the Z-axis. So we could just have it do that. So on hover, we're flipping it. You can see it's not just flipping the text itself, it's flipping the entire box, including its shadow. So we're doing that. It's not enough. Let's go in again with the button selected, hover. Let's go to rotate. Instead of 180 degrees, let's continue to rotate until, so I'll just say when.
Is this what you mean by like turning minds?
Sure. So we'll just keep going. Let's 2449, looks pretty good. So what'll happen? We hover over, it's kind of glitching. So what's happening there, the reason it's glitching, is because the boundary of that box has changed, right? As it rotates, you're no longer hovering over the spot that you were over before, so it'll glitch. But that's not the only point. It doesn't look, it physically doesn't look like, what was it, 2449? Yeah, 2449. It doesn't look like that. So we need to add a second transition. So with transition selected, we had 400 millisecond box shadow. We're gonna add another one, this time for transforms. And now if we hover over, it's a little abrupt, but you can see it's going that full 2,449. Maybe 200 is a little fast. Maybe you want to slow it down to something like 20,000 or 20 seconds. What'll that look like? So we can go to preview and hover over and see that over 20 seconds, we're having that rotation apply. We could, if we want, by default, if we don't like that type of transform, we could say instead of ease, we can go into, you know, ease out. We can pick any of these. We can even design our own easing curves to make it really dramatic here. In fact, maybe the progress should be really quick at first and it'll smooth out over time. That looks good. So hover over. And so
yeah,
it's looking pretty good. So the last part of it will take how long?
A long time.
Almost 20. It'll actually take 20 seconds exactly. And if we hover out, we're getting that same effect.
This is it?
Yeah. This is the design.
Okay, sure. Yeah.
That's animating a button. Let's move into a page load animation. So page load animation essentially says, when the page loads, play this animation. So we have to define that animation property. So what we can do is we can switch over to interactions. Two types of triggers. Essentially, an element trigger is applied on the element. So it would be clicking an element, affecting that element in some way. But a page trigger is something that applies on the page. So a good example would be, while the mouse is moving in the viewport, or while your page is scrolling, or like we're gonna use, page load. So when the page loads, we'll click that. When the page starts loading, we can do whatever. And when the page finishes loading, we can do whatever. This is helpful down the road if you want a page loader animation or something like that. For us, when the page starts loading, we wanna start right away with this animation. So when the page starts loading, we wanna perform an action. What kind of action? We want an animation. So start an animation. We have none yet. We haven't created an animation, so we're going to create our first animation. We'll call it our first animation. So we can do anything here. For example, maybe we want the heading to be selected. So on our first animation, when the page loads, we want the heading to maybe move. That's okay. So maybe we want the heading to move to the right a little bit. Just demonstrating here. What happens when the page loads now? The heading moves to the right. So we're going to make this a lot better. The move was just an example. What we can actually do, let's zero that out, is say, we actually want, when the page loads, we want this to start a little lower. So let's say 40 pixels down. Is 40 okay?
Yeah,
40 down. And instead of moving down 40, because if we hit play now, when we load the page, it'll just kind of move randomly down. Not very good. Instead, what if we make this our initial state? So our initial state is that it's 40 pixels down. So let's check that. Now it's our initial state. That means we need one more keyframe, one more action. So let's do that. So up here, let's add another keyframe down here. We're gonna move. And instead of moving down 40 or doing something else, let's press zero. Let's type zero here in the y-axis, our vertical axis, and press return. So let's look at our points again. This point, it's saying our initial state, when the page loads, be 40 pixels down. And then here, be zero. So if we hit play now, it moves into its final position. That's okay. There's some things that could be better. First off, it's linear. Let's put some ease on that. Let's do ease in out, and quad. Now hit play. You want quad?
Yeah.
Ease in out quad?
Quart.
You gotta pick one. Quad, quart, what do you want?
With a T.
In out, oh, quart.
Yeah.
Okay. In out, quart?
That was what I said.
Okay. So play, ooh, that's, you sure?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it. Over how many seconds, one?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go, play. All right, looking good.
Yeah.
Let's do more. Let's say in our initial state, so to the left here, we wanna add opacity. So initially we want the opacity to be zero. So if we hit play now.
It's zero.
It's zero, that's because we need that second point. So to the left of our point here, this point where we moved everything to zero, let's add opacity and let's make that, instead of zero, let's drag that all the way up to 100 and now we're animating it in. Again, we can select two things at once, just hold down shift, select both of these, and we could switch, what do you say, in, out, quart?
Yep.
Okay. And 1 second, we can apply settings on both of them at once. Now if we hit play, it'll match. But we're just getting started because we can make this so much better. So, oh, there we go. Okay, so there's a few things here. So we know we have the heading and that's what we've moved so far, but we want to do a lot more, right? We have the hero paragraph, we have this amazing button, we have this image. There's a lot we want to do here. So we could just say all of these, we want to add, let's say on this one, we want to add something that affects opacity and we want to affect something that moves. We want to do the same here, opacity and move. And we want to do the same on the button. We want opacity and move.
Yes.
And down here, we want opacity and move. Finally, on the image, we want, you guessed it, opacity and move. And of course, down here, opacity and move. So what we're just doing is creating those keyframes, and now we can select all of these at once. For instance, just holding down Command or Control on Windows, we just select all of our moves at once, and we can apply the same properties to all of them. We could say they're all gonna be 40 pixels by default. And do the same thing with opacity. We can say all the ones, we're just holding down Command, select all of these, set the opacity to 0%, that's where we wanna start, And then down here, we can affect the same. We can say, we know we want all of the options with opacity to be selected and we want them to be at 100%, so we just type 100%. And we can do the same thing with move. Select each of our moves and we'll set it to 0 pixels. Now it shows 0 pixels right now, but we wanna make sure it's adding that property. So we'll type 0 and press return. Or just to be safe, we could just hit up, go up to 5 and down to 0. So we make sure we're resetting all of those at once just to make sure it catches. So the final thing we wanna do with any one of these selected, we'll select all of them like that. We know we wanna change that ease in out court over 1 second, or we can do 5 seconds for right now. We can hit play. We see all of those elements over 5 seconds, ease in out court. Again, one was better. So make it 1 second. You can see them all play at once. Now, one thing to note, while it still looks good over 1 second, notice how the button looks a little bit different. That could be because we kept that legacy brilliant style we created before. Let's make sure we're removing that transform. And frankly, let's go into our hover and make sure we're removing that massive 3D transform. And let's go back in, into our page load, our first animation. Let's hit play again, and it's even and matched. Looks pretty good. Now, what if we want to break these things up? What if we don't want all these things happening at once? This will be really straightforward. Maybe we want to start with the big heading. So we could just take, let's take big heading out of this for a second. Let's just take it out. We're just going to drag this out. And we'll take both of the, it doesn't matter because they happen at the same time. We'll take both of them out. Let's do the same thing for that paragraph. Hold down shift. We're going to drag it out so it's its own chunk. Same thing with the button. Let's take that out. Let's put that underneath. And then image, let's just move that to the end. So what'll happen now if we hit play? If we hit play, it'll sequence these things. They all have the same initial starting point, but it'll sequence these things in order. So let's take a look at what happens. Press play, over 1 second we get the heading, the paragraph, the button, and the image. We're getting there. So for these, let's select all 6 of these. And let's actually say, instead of having them sequenced like this, let's drag them right back in so they all occur at this time. But let's just add a delay in each of them. So again, if we hit play right now, they all work, but what if we want these two to be delayed by, let's say,
0.2.
0.2, okay. And then we want the button delayed by 0.4. And then we want the hero paragraph or the image delayed by 0.6. Now it'll sequence in order like that. And if we want to increase the time a little bit, maybe 1.5, and we think that the in-out court looks ridiculous, we can change it to just ease in out, hit play.
That looks great.
Maybe there's a compromise. We can compromise on something like in-out quad. Hit play. Looks smooth. One more thing we might want to do is something on the nav bar. So we can have its initial state. So up here, let's add its initial opacity might be 0. We could just say when the page starts loading, we could just change that opacity to 100. We know this in out quad, and we could just say over 1.5 seconds. If we hit play now, it fades in. Looks pretty good. And that is it. We created our button, our animated transition, which definitely turned heads and minds. We created a page load animation where the trigger is the page loading and the animation is what happens on the screen. But of course, we have only one more core lesson to go after this. We'll review the full site and we'll examine the design. We'll also take a look at accessibility, all of this before publishing our site for the world to see.
The power of interactions isn't limited to the web. In this top secret Webflow feature, you can add buttons to a site that trigger continuity changes in actual videos. Lighting, set design, even my clothes. And remember, please subscribe. I need more coffee.